Hey everyone, it's Gia, week two of my video blogging, and I wanted to say thanks for being here, and I want to share a little story with you today and also ask you a question at the end. So this goes back to right after college. When I finished college, I left Washington State, where I'm originally from, and moved to Reno. So while I was there, it was summertime, and I really wanted to find a job that was totally outside of anything I'd been studying, which was elementary education. So there's a few places I've always wanted to work, one being a bookstore. So ironically, in Reno, there was a brand new Barnes & Noble that went in. So I decided to apply, went there, got the job, was very excited, and super inspired to be working in a bookstore with fun, tons of fun books around and magazines. And I wanted to meet some authors and the amazing people that come in looking for books. So I was so excited for this new little adventure for the summer. So I picked up my paperwork, brought it home, started to read it. And of course, here comes the fine print that's about this big that says dress code. I was like, No. I don't like dress codes. What's it going to say? So I read it and it said, I thought maybe it won't be so bad. No big deal. I can always, you know, whatever, tame my hair or I don't know, whatever. So I look at the dress code and it says closed-toed shoes and nylons. And I was like, are you kidding me? It's Reno where it gets to be like 100 degrees in the summertime. The last thing I'm going to do is wear closed-toed shoes and nylons in extreme heat. And it's not even me or how I dress or wear or whatever. So I decided at that moment that being myself was more important than taking this job. And ironically, I ended up getting this other job that was super fabulous and I could be totally myself. That's another story, different day. But what I realized was this has happened to me throughout my life where I've had these choices to make where, you know, I could decide to either do something because the opportunity is more important to me or and jeopardize a little bit of who I am or be myself and keep looking for something where I can be me and do what I love. So I call it my no matter what. So my no matter what is I have to be me no matter what. So if I'm not me, if I'm not dressing how I want to dress, if I'm not acting how I want to act, if I have to be a certain way or show up at an event, you know, as in this different role that's not who I am, it doesn't work for me. It's too fake. And I feel totally gross inside. So my no matter what is I have to be me no matter what. I want to know what's your no matter what. Or do you have one? Or have you even thought about it? So think about it. Let me know what's your no matter what. And I want to hear what you have to say about closed-toed shoes and nylons. Thanks for watching again this week. Can't wait to catch you next week. Have a fabulous, beautiful fall day. See you soon. Bye-bye.